Today we are making a recipe of chocolate fudge. This is a very interesting recipe. It has a flavor of caramel as well as chocolate, and it can stay as it is for up to 15 days. Hey foodies, welcome to CookingShooking. Many of you have been wanting me to make a chocolate dessert. Today we are going to make a butterscotch chocolate fudge. Very easy to make it as well. So let's get cooking. Let's begin the recipe. First, we are going to make the butterscotch sauce at home for our butterscotch chocolate fudge. Here I have a kadhai heated in high flame. I'm going to add 100 grams of sugar. This is regular white sugar that we regularly eat at our homes. Just spread the sugar in the kadhai so that it can melt evenly. We are not going to add any water to this and just melt it with the heat. While that is happening, we are also going to mix some fresh cream and some milk. Here I have 100 ml of fresh cream and I am going to mix 50 ml of milk in this. We are going to add this later to our sugar mixture. Just keep this aside, we are going to get back to the sugar. We want to melt the sugar with the heat itself, as I said earlier. So you can use a spoon and keep mixing it every now and then. Just ensure to break the lumps as often as possible. At this stage where half of the sugar is melted, we are going to lower the flame to low and then continue to melt it until we get a very nice amber color. We are basically making caramel in dry method. Right now, as you can see, the sugar has started to go golden and I have broken almost all the lumps. We are going to continue to cook it until we get slight frothiness in this. We don't want to burn the sugar. Keep the flame very low and then just continue to mix it. At this stage, the sugar can burn any moment. You can see there are very small bubbles right now. This is in the perfect stage for making butterscotch sauce. I'm going to turn off the flame quickly and then we are going to scotch the butter. Here I have about 30 grams of butter, which is about 2 tablespoons. I'm going to quickly add it and then carefully start mixing it. See the frothiness and the bubbles? We are basically scotching the butter for the butterscotch sauce. Once the bubbles subside, we are going to start the flame and then we are going to add the cream and milk mixture. Be very careful, this can spill, so use a big pan and then add little at a time. Keep mixing it. You will see a few lumps here and there, but don't worry, as we continue to cook it, those will get melted. Looks really nice, the color is really great and it has not spluttered, which is great for me. Be careful you guys, this can get very hot. Our butterscotch sauce is done, you can see it is bubbling, it is thick, it is creamy. I'm going to now turn off the flame and take it off the flame. While this is cooling down, we are going to prepare the chocolate. Here I'm using dark chocolate compound, you can also use real chocolate for this recipe. In this recipe of fudge, we are going to take 300 grams of chocolate. Here basically I'm dividing the chocolate into smaller chunks. You can chop it as fine as you like, but it really doesn't matter. So after chopping the chocolate, as you can see, I'm going to measure it. We want to ensure this is about 300 grams. Basically 3 times of the sugar. This is done. Similarly, I'm going to measure the butterscotch sauce. If you follow the recipe precisely, you will get exactly 150 grams of butterscotch sauce. And the third and final ingredient for now is condensed milk. We are going to measure it. Same quantity guys, 150 grams. So everything is done and ready. Our chocolate is ready, butterscotch sauce is ready and condensed milk is also ready. Now let's make the fudge. We are going to heat a non-stick pan right now. You can use a fry pan or a kadhai, whatever you have handy. Heat it in medium flame and then we are going to add the butterscotch sauce and the condensed milk. First, I am adding the butterscotch sauce. Try to remove out all of it. Don't leave it in the sides of your bowl. Similarly, we are going to take out all of the condensed milk. These both are very delicious and add a lot of value to our fudge, so don't waste any. The step right now is to give it a really nice mix. As you can see, this looks very similar to Alpenliebe candy. Delicious, isn't it? We are going to give it a mix and then bring it to a simmer. This step will only take about a minute or two. Once you see small bubbles like this in the corner, turn off the flame and then we are going to add the chocolate to this. Make sure to add chocolate only after turning off the flame, otherwise your chocolate will burn and seize. Mixing the chocolate with the hot butterscotch sauce and the condensed milk will take a while, about 3 or 4 minutes or so. Take your time, mix it gently and nicely from all the corners, and then you will have something similar to this. Here our fudge is ready, now we are going to set it. To set the fudge, here I am using a 8.5 inch square pan. You can use anything that you have handy. Just line it with some parchment paper or some butter paper and then you can spoon it out. With an 8.5 inch tin like this, you will get slightly thinner fudges. I like thinner fudges because it tastes like candy. You can also use a smaller pan for thicker fudges, something similar to brownie. After transferring this to the pan, it is ready. Now I'm going to let it stay as it is, idle for about 30 minutes so that it can dry out a little bit. After that, we are going to keep it in the fridge for 3 to 4 hours. So I've kept the fudge for about 8 hours or so, basically overnight in the fridge, and it is ready. Now we are going to take it out and then slice it. If you have used parchment paper, then it will be super easy for you. Just peel it off and then you can use a knife to cut it. Also keep some water handy nearby. If you keep your knife in the freezer for about 30 minutes before cutting, it will be super easy for you. So make the slices and keep some water handy. You can see how I am dipping the knife in some water. This is room temperature water. After that, I am wiping it with a cloth. Guys, this is fudge and it will be fudgy and sticky, so don't worry, take your time, slice the fudge and then you can decorate it with some cocoa powder or some nuts. Here I have chopped the fudge into bite-sized pieces. This looks super delicious. Now we are going to decorate it with some cocoa powder. Here I am using some basic cocoa powder, not some Dutch processed one because that is very dark. This we are going to add to a tea strainer and then we are going to just tap it or strain over the fudge. This will bring a very nice bitter flavor to our fudge, which is really delicious. So our fudge is done. You can keep it in the room temperature or even the fridge, doesn't matter. It is super delicious. This recipe will stay easily for up to 15 days, but I bet you it won't last even 15 minutes if you are a chocolate fanatic like me. You can look at the texture, that looks amazing, isn't it? So do give it a try. So there you go guys, our homemade butterscotch chocolate fudge is ready. It is absolutely delicious recipe guys. Usually when we eat fudge, we are used to eating a chocolate fudge. This one has a hint of butterscotch as well, caramel as well. That is absolutely sensational. Once you take a bite, you're not going to stop if you are a chocolate fanatic, as I said earlier. So thank you for watching. One small tip, if you're storing this for a long time, don't switch the temperature now and then. In the sense, don't keep it in the fridge for 1 hour, then 1 hour outside the fridge. Best to keep it one place, otherwise it will get affected by the condensation. I keep it in the fridge. Whenever I want to serve, just take out some, serve it, and it's ready to enjoy. So thank you for watching. Do like the video if you did, dislike it if you did not like it. See you soon with one more delicious recipe. Bye bye.